to go. The home plate umpire, Jerry Meals, says yes. And they're barking out of that Brewer dugout. And somebody just got ejected. And Andy Haines, the hitting coach, very upset. He may have been the one that got tossed. Hasn't been the best night, let's face it, for Jerry Meals, if you've been watching all night.
Yeah, well, he kicked the call down to first base that allowed the Cleveland Indians to tie the game.
Hold up, the plate umpire kicked a call at first base? Let's see that.
And it's not so much the Brewers are complaining about, you know, the call that he went. It's just that it felt like Jerry Meals should have asked for help. Didn't look like he went either.
This is one of the most misunderstood rules of baseball. The plate umpire, umpire-in-chief, is supposed to call decisions on check swings, all decisions on the batter themselves. If they don't think the batter went, you can appeal their decision to the base umpire. But if the plate umpire does think that the batter made an attempt to strike the pitch, they, by rule, are supposed to call it themselves. If you don't like the rule or the procedure, that letter should be addressed to MLB corporate, not the umpires who are told by MLB to call it a certain way. That said, let's go to the game-tying play and the alleged call kicked at first base by the plate umpire.
Ground ball to home, to first, and it hits to Shields. Ball is loose, and the Indians are going to tie this game up as the Brewers were going for the double play to try to end it.
Let's see if he was out of the running lane.
Okay, this is a runner's lane interference play. We've done this a lot of times before. Visit us, closecallsports.com. Look for running lane interference, runner's lane interference for previous rules elucidations on this topic. But what we're looking for here are twofold. Number one, did this runner, batter runner, run within the confines of the running lane on his way to first base before stepping out at the last stride or two? Number two, was the throw going to retire the runner reasonably? Was it a reasonable throw from the catcher to the first baseman? We can't see from this angle how the runner was running the whole time, but this next angle is going to show us that the runner was not in the lane at any point, and that the throw, yes, in my judgment, because it was on the fair side of the base, could have retired the runner. The commentator is right in this situation. This is runner's lane interference.